Hello children, once again welcome to our session. So let's continue with the same chapter, oscillations. So we had discussed about the time period of oscillation of a spring and simple pendulum in the previous session. Today let's continue with the same concept. Now we can discuss about damped simple harmonic motion. So what do you mean by damped simple harmonic motion? Damped simple harmonic motion can be stated as the motion in which amplitude of the oscillating body reduces and eventually comes to its mean position. You might have noticed, whenever the pendulum is set into oscillation, after some time the amplitude of the oscillation decreases and finally the pendulum comes to rest. So that is damped simple harmonic motion. And what could be the reason for this oscillation, decrease in the amplitude of the oscillation? Because the pendulum is oscillating through a medium which is our air. So that air offers some resistive forces on that pendulum, due to which its amplitude decreases and eventually or finally it comes to rest. Similarly, just observe a child swinging on a swing. Okay, so what happens? After some time, the amplitude of oscillation of that swing decreases and finally the child comes to rest. This is because the resistance offered by the medium, here it is air on that swing. Okay, so such cases of simple harmonic motion can be regarded as damped simple harmonic motion. Amplitude of the body reduces and eventually it comes to rest at its mean position. And dissipating forces cause damping, that is the resistive forces cause damping. Now consider a pendulum which is oscillating. After some time we can observe that its displacement starts decreasing and finally it comes to rest. This implies that there is some resistive force which opposes the motion of that pendulum. This type of simple harmonic motion is known as damped simple harmonic motion. Okay, this type of simple harmonic motion is known as damped simple harmonic motion. Now what is damping force? Damping force opposes the motion of the body. That's why the amplitude of the oscillation decreases and finally the object comes to rest. So damping force is the force which opposes the motion of the body. Magnitude of damping force is proportional to the velocity of the body, and the direction of the damping force is opposite to the direction of velocity. So the damping force is denoted by Fd, where d is the damping force, and Fd will be directly proportional to velocity, and at the same it is opposite to velocity. So we can write damping force Fd is opposite to velocity, and at the same time it is proportional to velocity, and at the same time it is opposite to velocity, and that is indicated by this negative sign. And to remove this proportionality sign we will add a constant, and that constant is b, small b, which can be considered as the damping constant. So minus b into v is the expression for damping force that is written here, where b is the damping constant. And it depends on the characteristics of the medium, that is viscosity or something like that, and size and shape of the block, etc. Okay, and this damping force is opposite to velocity, you must remember that. Now what is the equation for damped oscillations? So in order to find out an equation for damped oscillation, consider a pendulum which is oscillating, and that pendulum will experience two forces. One is the restoring force minus kx, and another one is the damping force minus bv. So the total force experienced by the pendulum will be minus kx plus minus bv. Okay, so minus kx plus minus bv will become minus itself. So minus kx minus bv, this will be the total force experienced in a damped oscillation. Because where in the case of damped oscillation, it experiences a damping force as well as the restoring force minus kx. And let's suppose a is the acceleration of the block. So we know that F total is ma. Okay, force is mass into acceleration ma. So we can write, in the previous slide we got F total as minus kx minus bv, minus kx minus bv. So this F total, instead of F total we can write mass into acceleration, ma, ma equal to minus kx minus bv. Okay, or we can just rearrange like this, that is minus kx minus bv equal to ma. Okay, so that is written here, minus kx minus bv equal to ma, and where a is the acceleration, and a can be written as d square x by dt square. Okay, so minus kx minus bv equal to m into d square x by dt square, or m into d square x by dt square, bring this minus bv and minus kx to RHS part, so you will get m into d square x by dt square plus kx plus bv equal to 0, or m into d square x by dt square plus, write this bv first, so b into v, v is the velocity, and velocity can be written as dx by dt, isn't it? So instead of velocity, write b into dx by dt plus kx equal to 0. Now this is a differential equation. Okay, so here multiply, sorry, divide this equation throughout by small m. So when you divide this equation throughout by small m, you will get d square x by dt square plus b by m into dx by dt plus k by m into x equal to 0. Okay, so this is the differential equation for the damping case. Okay, in the absence of damping, the equation might have been d square x by dt square plus k by m into x equal to 0. This was the equation in the absence of damping. Do you remember this equation? We got this expression just before. Okay, and when damping is present, then the equation will be d square x by dt square plus b by m dx by dt plus k by m x. Okay. Now after solving that differential equation, you will get an expression for x, and that expression is x of t equal to a e raised to minus bt by 2m into cos omega dash t plus 5. You must study this expression by heart. This is the solution for the differential equation that we got just now, that is for this differential equation d square x by dt square. So for this equation, when you solve this equation, you will get an expression for x, and that expression is x is equal to a e raised to minus bt by 2m into cos omega dash t plus 5. Okay, so remember this expression, and damping is caused by the term e raised to minus bt by 2m. Okay, so this is the additional term here, and this is the damping term e raised to minus bt by 2m. And omega is the frequency, but omega dash is the angular frequency in the presence of damping. And this omega dash can be written as square root of k by m minus b square by 4m square. So in the absence of damping, omega was just square root of k by m. But in the presence of damping, omega will become omega dash, and the expression for omega dash will be k by m. Minus one additional term will come here, that is the damping term b square by 4m square. So that is the difference. So this is the angular frequency in for a damped oscillation. And in this expression, if you put b equal to 0, you will get omega dash equal to square root of k by m, which is equal to the angular frequency omega in the absence of damping. Okay, so remember the expression solution for damped harmonic oscillator, expression for angular frequency for a damped oscillation. Now graphically, if we plot damped oscillation, there is exponentially decrease in the amplitude with respect to time. So here you can see, so this is the amplitude initially, after some time the amplitude has been decreased, after some time the amplitude has been decreased, again it has been decreased. So every time the amplitude has been decreasing with respect to time. So this is the graphical representation of a damped harmonic oscillator. Now free oscillations, another type of oscillation is free oscillation. So what is free oscillation? In this type of oscillation, amplitude and time period remain constant. It does not change. This means there is no damping. But in real scenario, there is no system which has constant amplitude and time period. Okay, so when a body oscillates in the absence of any external forces, friction, the oscillations are said to be free oscillation. This is just a theoretical case or ideal case. In reality, we cannot find any free oscillation. If we want to find the free oscillation, we want to evacuate. That means if we do the simple pendulum experiment in space, it may happen we can see the free oscillations. Okay, because in space nothing is there to provide the friction. Next type of oscillation is forced oscillations. See, forced oscillation, from the name itself we can understand, if we apply some external force to keep the oscillations continue, such oscillations are known as forced oscillations. In forced oscillations, the system oscillates not with natural frequency but with the external frequency. Suppose the child is swinging on a swing. After some time, the amplitude of the swing will decrease, start to decrease. At that time, if we push that swing from behind, it will continue to oscillate with the same amplitude, isn't it? So that is forced oscillation. If we apply some external force to keep the oscillations continue, such oscillations are known as forced oscillation. And once we apply the external force, that system will start to oscillate with the external frequency. That means with the frequency of the force that we have applied. So once we apply the force, the system does not oscillate with its natural frequency, but it oscillates with the external frequency. Example for forced oscillation is when a child in a garden swing periodically presses his feet against the ground, or someone else periodically gives the child a push to maintain the oscillations. And another important phenomena of this chapter is resonance. Resonance is the phenomenon of increase in amplitude when the driving force is close to the natural frequency of the oscillator is called resonance. So driving force means the force which we apply to an object to maintain its oscillation. That is the driving force. And when that driving force becomes equal to the natural frequency of that oscillator, it is called resonance. Because when the driving force becomes equal to the natural frequency of the oscillator, maximum amplitude is observed. And this maximum amplitude condition is known as resonance. If an external force with angular frequency omega d acts on an oscillating system with natural frequency omega, the system oscillates with angular frequency omega d. Okay, so if an external force with angular frequency omega d is applied on an oscillating system, and suppose the natural frequency of that oscillating system is omega, then what happens? This is when the both the frequencies becomes equal, the system oscillates with the angular frequency omega d, and the amplitude of the oscillation will be the greatest. This is importance. Resonance means maximum amplitude of oscillation. That is, driving frequency will be equal to natural frequency, and this expression is called resonance. Swings are very good examples of resonance. You can see swings oscillate at the maximum amplitude sometimes, and this happens when the external force becomes equal to the natural frequency. Natural frequency means the frequency with which it oscillates without any force. Okay, graphically we can express resonance like this. This will be the graph of resonance. Okay, which means this is the maximum amplitude, and this maximum amplitude is obtained for the frequency omega d. This happens when omega, natural frequency, becomes equal to the driving frequency omega d. For all other frequencies, the amplitude starts to decrease on either sides. Only when this condition is achieved, when omega or natural frequency becomes equal to the driving frequency, maximum amplitude is observed. So many examples can be cited on the basis of resonance. All mechanical structures have one or more natural frequencies, and if a structure is subjected to a strong external periodic force that matches with one of this frequency, resulting oscillations of the structure may rupture it. You might have noticed, so the bridge may collapse. So to avoid this, marching soldiers break their steps while crossing a bridge. Okay. Now, also you might have noticed one more thing. Aircraft designers make sure that none of the natural frequencies at which the wing can oscillate match the frequency of engines in the flight. Why? Because again, when matching of frequencies occurs, resonance may occur, which may lead to a plane crash. Okay, so all these are applications or examples of resonance. So resonance means maximum amplitude condition. So with this, I'm concluding this chapter. So our physics portions are over, and one more chapter is there, that is kinetic theory of gases. And I'm not taking that chapter for you because you had already studied most of the things in your chemistry portions, Boyle's law, Charles' law, ideal gas, etc., etc. So most of the things are related to chemistry itself. So with this, I'm concluding our physics portion. Notes of the topic have been uploaded. Please go through it. We will meet in the next revision session. So till then, take care all of you. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.